Hey, good morning and Merry Christmas. Yes, Merry Christmas. We are celebrating the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and how it is that God the Father sent his one and only Son, Jesus, for you and for me. Why did he do that? To take care of us eternally. Christ spilled out, he shed his holy blood, his perfect blood, holy sacrifice, once and for all, making us right with God forever. It is the greatest gift that you and I could ever be given, and God has given Jesus for you and for me. All right, so we are celebrating Christmas. Now, we're celebrating Christmas at Christ Fellowship Church in a different way this year. We're not going to be having Christmas Eve service, but instead, we're going to have a Christmas communion service this Sunday at 5 p.m., Sunday the 20th at 5 p.m. We're inviting you to invite friends, family, coworkers, whoever it is. This is a tremendous invite for somebody. What we're going to do is we are going to worship the Lord with Christmas carols, and we're going to celebrate communion. We've ordered these special communion kits so that you can take this individually without any fear of it being contaminated. Nobody else is going to be touching it. So we have these special communion kits. So we're going to celebrate communion together, and we're going to be in the Word. And so it's just going to be a great time. And so invite your friends and family to that. We are also going to be having our online service on Sunday morning, as well as our in-person service. And so all of the above. Now, the in-person service as well as the online service will be different than the communion service. But that's what's in front of us coming into this Sunday. All right. Now, let's look today. We're in Galatians chapter 6, verses 5 and 6, two verses. And so as we look to Galatians 6, verse 5, this is another verse where it would be easy to get confused. Paul says in verse 5, "For each one should carry his own load." And so, well, now, wait a minute, Paul. I thought you said in verse 2 that we're to carry one another's burdens, and in this way, fulfill the law of Christ. Yeah, Paul said both. Now, this is where it's important to get into the Greek, because the word in verse 2 for burden is quite different than the word in verse 5 for load. They're two different words. See, the word in Greek for burden in verse 2 refers to something that's too heavy for us to carry alone. We're not meant to carry that alone. It's so weighty that it would literally squash us. And so this is the beauty of the body of Christ. As we walk together with other believers in Jesus, that we can share those burdens that are too heavy for us to bear. They would squash us. They're too heavy. But in verse 5, this is different. Paul is referring to, in fact, if you look at the Greek, that word for load refers to a knapsack. Or we might think of it as a backpack, a typical backpack, not a backpack that is so heavy that we're weighed down. No, this would be a backpack that would be somewhat normal, that we can carry. You see, what's being looked at here is your accountability before the Lord and my accountability before the Lord, that I am responsible in the Lord for the gifts and talents, for everything that he's entrusted me with, and that I have to answer to him alone for that. God's not going to hold me accountable for somebody else's life, nor is he going to hold you accountable for somebody else's life. You'll be accountable for the life that he's called for you in him, that all of your talents, all of your gifts, who you are, and the way that you live for the kingdom and for his glory, that's what we're looking at here. And in this way, I have to carry my own load, just as you have to carry your own load. It's what we are going to come before the Lord with in accountability. Now we look at verse 6, and then Paul says, "Nevertheless, the one who receives instruction in the word must share in all good things with his instructor." You say, well, what is Paul saying here? This is actually a euphemism. Paul is referring to the way that we would pay the elder teacher, or what we would know as the pastor of the church, in that the elder teacher, given the time needed to prepare God's word and to preach God's word and to serve God's people, is to be cared for. And so that we're to help financially for that pastor, for that teacher, for that teaching elder in our midst. And so, yeah, this is not something that is just thought up by people, by men. No, this is actually put in place in the New Testament, in God's word, for the one who is preaching the gospel, for the one who is sharing God's word with God's people and equipping God's word with God's people, that we're to take care of that one, that teaching elder, that pastor. All right, let's pray. Lord, we thank you for today, and our lives belong to you today. We cling to you, as the psalmist says. We cling to you. Our souls cling to you. And Lord, we know that your right hand upholds us. And so we are so grateful for the way that we celebrate Jesus. We celebrate the coming of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord Jesus, for giving us everything we need, the perfect gift. And we thank you, Lord, for the life that we have in and with and through you. And all glory is for you. Thank you, God. We pray it in your name. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, listen, tomorrow we're going to be in verses 7 and 8, and we'll see you then.